رحمه الله حفظه الله تعالى. So when the people actually look, did you know brothers here, love brothers here, did you know that atheism was not known in Egypt at the time of Mubarak?
Yes.
Doesn't mean I'm praising Mubarak. Understand me correctly. Doesn't mean I believe everything Mubarak did was right. No.
He was dolim.
But akhi, it was dolim of him, of course, dolim. However, when it comes to deen, he protected the people's deen. Shia was not allowed to spread, and atheism. After Mubarak, first country that atheism started spreading out openly, Egypt. Egypt, you know, that's why sometimes this hakim maybe is causing much problems, but it's protecting the greater issues. Yes, understand. So we have to be wise, and doesn't mean I said it clearly and openly. People that call for rebellion in Muslim countries, they are donkeys. I call them donkeys, and I call them enemies of Allah in this bab, in this specific, because Allah said clearly, do not cause a fitan, and they want a fitan to be caused. You know, that's how many man, how you doing? Long time, bro. How's everything? You know, recording? All right, cool. So understand, because enough is enough.
Wallah.
Look what's happened in Syria, where we praise Jahsh.
No.
What happened in Libya? Even that, but there is a power, brother. People coming out with
the Kafir rule the Muslims.
If we are unable to remove him, then yes.
Space. Even just hold it.
If it's allowing you to pray.
Okay.
Akhi, Al-Arifi. You know Al-Arifi? Yeah. This guy, like what do they call him? Who changed his color?
Chameleon.
Okay. before people rebelled in Syria, we said, I want Syria. Mashallah, the door is open for me. Yeah. They treat me nice. No, before that. They treat me nice in Syria. I spoke in the masjid openly. Al-Sunnah good in Syria. When the people rebelled, he started praising the people, says he's an evil man. Yeah. Why? I had a gun, now he's made tawbah. But before, when he was speaking to the leader of Yemen, you're the best leader of the Arabs, you're a good leader. When the people rebelled, he started. Likewise, Salman al-Houda and Gas Qaddafi, his sons, as the son of Qaddafi, exposed them. They are scholars for dollars. They are the ones who take money. As for Sheikh Rabi', Sheikh Uthaymeen, Sheikh Fawzan, Al-Luhaydan, Al-Abbad, none of that, alhamdulillah. Sheikh Rabi' has a horse in his socks. Go visit him, alhamdulillah. And you know, Sheikh Rabi' never maybe traveled to Europe. Sheikh Bin Baz never had a passport. Then you go talk about Sheikh Bin Baz, akhi. Sheikh Uthaymeen. Sheikh Uthaymeen, just a side point. Sheikh Uthaymeen, the leader came to him. He said, I want to buy. He said, you have a small house here. I'm going to buy for you, what they call it. I'm going to buy a palace for you, big house. He said, no. I have a house. I'm getting it ready. He says, where? He says, such a place. His children, they start looking at each other. What's going on? Our father lying? Or would he know that? When the king left, they came to their father. He said, Sheikh, what's going on? He said, you are getting a house ready in such place. He said, yes, the house in the grave. My grave in the graveyard, in that place, I'm getting it ready. Then he says, close for doors, qabbahakum Allah. While in Europe, some of you in Europe saying rebel, and getting money from the government. I'm not saying it's a problem to get money from the government, but don't talk about our scholars to be scholars for dollars. When you are getting dollars in America, like Abu Qatada getting the money in this country, and speaking ill of Sheikh Ahmed says Al-Sunnah. Yes.
Abu Qatada gave his building to the student of knowledge, so the user.
Akhi Ahmed Al-Najmi. So the point here is, barakallahu fik, the condition he has to be fall into clear-cut cover in the Muslim countries, of course, and we have the ability to remove him, the people of Shawka.
But if he's like Kafir, like Assad, you still don't go against him if he's leaving Ahl Sunnah practice? And
no, if you are able to remove him, even if he's leaving us alone, but the people of Shawka, people of the army, the people of the Hal wal Aqd, to remove him.
Yeah.
But if they are unable and it's allowing the people to pray, then it's... You know, akhirallah, this fitna, khuruj. Wallah, I've noticed, I was saying the brother here, Ibrahim, many brothers who approach me, I'm not talking about you, but many brothers who focus more on khuruj, they don't even know the pillars of prayer. Wallah, they don't know. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first question you be asked on the day of resurrection, he's not going to ask you, what do you think about Tabun? Or what do you think about Muhammad Sadis? Or Muhammad bin Salman? Hal salayt? Wallahi, akhi, you know why? Because we don't want to take responsibility for our sins, our mistakes. We're gonna point fingers at the ruler. Akhi, in Algeria, there were this famous singer, I don't know him, he's a French singer. People killed each other just to see this person. Now tell me, did Sabun tell them, go, otherwise I'm gonna kill you? He didn't.
People want it.
People want it. People want it. Even Bouteflika, this, well, he's still alive, I believe. He said to them, there's a bar. I don't agree with that. This is nonsense. Yeah. You know, but for the sake, he said that. He said there is a bar and there is a mosque. If you want to go mosque, go mosque. Now, if you go bar, don't say Bouteflika forced me. Yeah. Understand? And wallahi, akhi, don't think your sabr and our patience with them is going to go to waste. Abadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge these people. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Abu Dhar al-Ghaffari came to him, he said, oh Messenger of Allah, appoint me to be in charge of something. He said, Abu Dhar, because Abu Dhar was a soft man, one of the great companions. He was from the ulama. He said, Abu Dhar, that's not for you. He said, Abu Dhar, innaha la amana. This rulership is a trust. Wa innaha yawm al-qiyama la khizyun wa nadam. Or the resurrection will be humiliation. Except the one who takes it with its rights. Understand, akhi? That's what Ahmad ibn Hanbal was asked. Listen to the a'imma of the Salaf. Ahmad ibn Hanbal was asked, who's better to have, a ruler that is fasiq but is strong, powerful, or a ruler that is a righteous man but is weak?
Powerful.
Powerful. He said he sins for himself, but his power and strength for the Muslims. Yeah. But his righteousness, the other one, his righteousness for himself. Yeah. His weakness will affect the Muslims.
Who said that?
Ibn Hanbal. Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned that in his kitab Siyasa Shar'iyya. Yeah, he said his righteousness is for himself, but his weakness is going to affect the Muslims. Akhi, Saddam, ya ikhwa, wallah, I've been watching videos. Shia crying for Saddam. Saddam was Dalim, of course. But he honored his people. He was a strong man. He ruled Iraqis. You understand? He was a very strong man. Was he committing the dolm? He was committing dolm. That's why, akhi, listen to Hikam. Qaddafi, akhi. Qaddafi, Libyans used to come here to study. Everything was good, akhi. You get, you know, dollars, it was very low in Libya. The Algerians used to go to Libya to buy dollars. Okay? Likewise, education is free. Healthcare is, medication is free. Right now? So there's a hikam when Allah leaves someone. I know that is the best way. Let us change ourselves, including myself. I have mistakes, I have sins. Let us correct ourselves. Then I correct my wife. My wife correct me. We correct our children. Then we still have good society. But we just focus on the rulers while we're doing evils. Then don't expect. This ruler came from us. Tabun didn't come from another planet. He came from us. He came from us.
Allah so let us. Because of what we do.
What
about the responsibility of ulama?
The ulama, yes, to advise. Da'wah and advice. Likewise, the leaders. Leaders have a big, akhi, the leaders have a big responsibilities. Alhamdulillah, I'm not a leader. Akhi, imagine Allah is asking you about 45 million people. Akhi, no, honey. Me, I have a problem with three daughters, let alone 45.
Wallah, yourself is enough.
Wallah, myself is enough. Barakallah. Let alone 45 million of people.
And the animals, like Umar ibn Khattab was scared that someone would overburden a camel and he would be asked about
Barakallah. That's why Umar ibn Khattab, when the Dawla Islamiyah, the Islamic Empire expanded, he said, oh Allah, I'm becoming very old and weak, and my ra'iyah, my people have increased, so take my life. Subhanallah. That's why you make dua for them. Because I don't believe, me personally, I don't believe Tabun is telling the guy who works in the hospital, before someone takes an x-ray, take £20 from him, even though it's for free. I don't believe Tabun saying that. Come on, akhi. Then now you're going to blame Tabun?
Allah yatihammu qawba. Hard work, man. The same thing happened in Morocco.
لا احنا قاعد من له وحده مروكو الجزائر تونس قاعد بواحد
فوان سمون الليدر لايك عمر بن الخطاب وي هاف تو بي لايك صحابه
بارك الله فيك if we want someone like ابن الخطاب then we have to be like صحابه now ابن الخطاب اخي ابن الخطاب في كوست سم موسم كانتريز now men are just like women you know what I'm saying just like women اخي come on اخي You know, so we have to fix ourselves first, including myself. Salaam alaikum, how are you doing?
Good, akhi. Sheikh, can I have a quick word with you? When you're free.
Okay.
When you're free.
Is it recording, akhi?
No,
bro, come on, I don't speak to Khariji. I don't speak to Khariji. Khariji, I give you my back. I give you my back, Khariji. So my point here, akhi, no, I don't speak to him. Akhi, the point here is, so, Sahaba, they are there. We have to be like Uthman and Ali and Talha ibn Ubaidullah. In order for us to Allah bless us with someone like Umar ibn Khattab. All of us have to fix ourselves, brothers. You understand? Including myself. So brothers, let's fix ourselves. Let us study. Let our deen. Well, as I've mentioned, I've noticed here, people more focus on hukam, hukam, hukam. Yeah. We have to learn, ikhwa. Wallahi, brothers, as I was saying, the brother, in Algeria, before football match starts, 2 hours people are there.
No, wallahi, it is.
Go massage for the time, it's empty. Am I blaming the people? Yes, I do blame them because in this bab, the people are able to choose either to go nightclub.
That way is weird. Why don't blame them?
There is a da'wah.
Yeah.
There is a da'wah.
No,
but akhi, look. Man, this story, listen to this story. Man came to Sheikh Uthaymeen. Yeah. He said, yeah, Sheikh, why don't you advise the leaders? Sheikh Uthaymeen said, we do. He said, but they don't listen. So just as we advise you to fear Allah, and you don't listen to. How many times the ulama said, fear Allah, stay away from this, stay away from the riba, stay away from that. And what, do we listen? See Ibrahim, wallahi Ibrahim, I know you believe you want. I believe you want khair. Baqi, wallahi, Allah Jalla wa Ala said, "La yansuranna Allahu man yansuruh." Allah will give victory to those who follow Allah's legislation. Wallahi, I'm not saying we have to be perfect. As I've mentioned, I'm the first person who commit sin and commit mistakes. But let us try. Let us, all of us, teach yourself, teach myself, and help one another. And you see how the, like Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what he did. Kuffar of Quraysh didn't want to listen. What he did, he started teaching the people. You see, he started teaching the people, Sahaba. Likewise, the story of Musa Alayhi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Musa, he came to Fir'aun. He called Fir'aun to Islam. Fir'aun doesn't want to listen. What Musa Alayhi Sallam did? Did he just focus on Fir'aun? Okay. What he did? He started teaching.
Fighting.
And also he did? He started teaching Bani Israel. Why? Because look what Bani Israel said to Musa Alayhi Sallam. He said, we used to get oppressed before you came. Now you came to us and we still getting oppressed. He said, Allah has given a promise, the meaning. Allah has given a promise that he will inherit this land to the righteous ones. What happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed Fir'aun and his army.
And on that point, I want to say that Allah, Musa is ordered by Allah, قُلْ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا to Fir'aun. To Fir'aun, you want people to chastise the
Hukam. Sheikh Sa'ad Fawzan mentioned that. Sheikh Sa'ad Fawzan, he said, who is worse than Fir'aun?
Allah, to be God.
What Allah said to him, he said, فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ أو يخشى لعله يذكر ويخشى يذكر ويخشى. The point here is, but also we have to be just. Also Allah أو يخشى يذكر ويخشى. Also Allah said about Musa, إني لا أظنك يا فرعون مثبورة. He said to him, also you're going to be destroyed. But لكل مقال مقال. So Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام, he was soft but also was harsh another time. When he noticed فرعون is not listening, he said فرعون أو فرعون. I can't see. Yeah. That's why أخي. Musa alayhi salam, what he did, he teach the people. You see, Allah gave them victory. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam likewise, so the Sahaba, and Allah gave them victory. Because Allah promised us, لَيَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ. Allah will give victory to those who give Allah victory. Khalas, we have to learn. Brothers, mashallah, I love you here. You go to college, you go to university, I don't know how your ages, then learn your deen and teach the people. Teach aqidah.